This video explains law of supply. Based on the behavior of sellers, the law of supply has been introduced. The law of supply states the direct relationship between price and quantity supplied, keeping other factors constant. So when price of the commodity increases, there is more supply of that commodity in the market and vice versa. So this behavior of producer is studied under the law of supply. So what are the assumptions of law of supply? Price of other goods is constant. No change in state of technology. Price of factors of production remains the same. No change in taxation policy. Goals of the producer remain the same. So these factors are keeping constant, and only the price and the supply of the product have been taken into an account. So here in the, to explain that, here you study the table here. At rupee 1, 10 units of the quantity supplied. Rupees 2, 20 units of quantity supplied. 3, 30, 4, 40 units. 5, 50 units. Now they are all plotted on the graph. So you find quantity supplied in units on x-axis and price on y-axis. And for 1 rupee, 10, 2 rupees, 20, 3 rupees, 20. So the plots are joined. So you get SS, the supply curve. So the supply curve, you find its slope upwards from left to right, indicating direct relationship between price and the quantity supplied. So what are the important points of law of supply? Positive relationship between price and quantity supplied, assuming other factors do not change. The next point is, it is a qualitative statement as it indicates direction of change in the quantity supplied, but it does not indicate the magnitude of change. The next one, it does not establish any proportional relationship between change in price and resultant change in quantity supplied. Law is one-sided as it explains only the effect of change in price on the supply, not the effect of change in supply on the price. So these are the points, important points about law of supply. So why the supply of commodity rises as the price rises? So the reasons are profit motive. The producers want to make maximum profits. So when price of the commodity changes without any change in cost, it raises the, because there is no change in the cost of production, the price of factors of production. So naturally, when he increases the price, it brings profit to him. So the producer increases the supply of commodity by increasing the production. Then next reason, change in number of firms. A rise in price induces the prospective producers to enter into the market to produce a given commodity to earn more profits. So increase in number of firms raises the market supply. When price falls, some firms do not expect to earn more profit, so at a low price, so either they stop the production or reduce the supply. The next one, change in stock. When the price of a good increases, the seller is ready to supply more goods from their stocks. So at relatively low price, the producer do not release high quantities or big quantities from their stock. So these are the reasons for law of supply. And what are the exceptions? The supply curve slope upwards, showing that quantity supply rises with the increase in price. But in some cases, positive relationship between supply and price may not hold true. Well, so what are the exceptions? Future expectation, if seller expect a fall in price, law of supply may not hold true. Sellers will be willing to sell more even at a low price. However, if they expect the price to rise in future, they would reduce the supply of the commodity in order to supply the commodity later at a high price. Then agricultural goods. The law of supply does not apply to agricultural goods as their production depends on climatic conditions. So, if there are changes, sudden changes in weather, the production of agricultural product is low, then their supply cannot be increased even at higher prices. The next, perishable goods. Sellers will be ready to sell more perishable goods like food, fruits, vegetables, even if the prices are falling, because sellers cannot hold it for longer time. And rare articles. The precious articles, rare articles are also outside the scope of law of supply. For example, a painting, rare painting of Mona Lisa or any other painting you find, the price cannot be, supply cannot be increased even if the prices are increased. Next, backward countries. Economically backward countries, you find production and supply cannot be increased with rise in price due to shortage of resources. So these are the exceptions. So law of supply cannot be applied in these conditions.